Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to make two boxes with the new Fab Scraps Christmas line. I got the page in parts that I want to use, and I have two white match boxes that are ready to decorate. You can make boxes yourself. I had these lying around and it saved some time. I'm going to use this strip I cut to size to fit the box, and I will show you how I cover one box. I put tape all around the outsides and on all the edges, so when I put the paper on, it stays nice and flat. By the way, I added the products I used in the description box for you, and if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. Now I put the image I want on the biggest part of the box in place, and then I start folding the paper around the box. Over the corners so they are very well attached. Cut off a piece of the paper that is too long. And then on the other side, add a piece of tape on the end and press it to the box. Now cut off the excess paper if there is any. I sand the edges, but you can also ink them if you like. I'm going to cover the seam with another piece of paper that I will mat on a red strip, and then I'm going to tape it to the box. Now cut off any excess parts. Now I will cover the inside box. I will add tape again, and then I will add a strip of paper I cut to size. Make sure you fold it around the shape. I took apart the inside flaps so I could add tape to fold them back, and then fold them around it or the paper will crack there. and then I add a piece on the bottom I measured to fit. Now I covered the other box too and I'm going to decorate them. I cut some flowers with a super thin Stick-It film. It goes right through the machine and cuts really well even with intricate dies. So I'm going to peel off the backing of the film and try to touch the flowers as little as possible. I kept the backing of the sticky sheet and I will use that in a bit. I sprinkle on the glitter and then put on the backing paper and press. This way the glitter, though it's really pretty, isn't all on your fingers. I cut some flowers and I'm going to ink the edges. I thought this color would match one of the colors in the paper. Now I make two hearts with a pearl pen. I tape the piece of backing sheet from double-sided film to cardboard and I will make my pearls on that. And because the cardboard is sturdy, I can pick it up and put it aside to dry. And now I'm going to shape the flowers. I use the ball tool from the Tonic Studios flower tool set and it's super easy and fast. And now I wanted a bit of red on the flowers, so I add some red ink. And then I assemble the flowers. My flower hearts are dry, so I'm going to add them to the center. Two pretty flowers done. Now it's time to assemble. I add some silver thread and I put that on a piece of tape I put on the box. And then I'm going to add the berries and the flowers. And this way you have a fun gift card box, or you can put a mini gift inside. By the way, if you feel inspired, I always love to see your make, so don't forget to use hashtag HerisCraftRoom when you want to share your work on social media. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and I love to see you in the next video. Thanks for watching!